I did a few speed tests using Speedify, and the first test I did was with a single wired connection. So without Speedify, I had an upload speed of 18.2 megabits per second, and when I enabled Speedify, the speed dropped down to 13.1 megabits per second. And I had encryption on and IP and DNS leak protection on as well. Then I used that same single connection, but I disabled encryption and also disabled IP and DNS leak protection. And with Speedify, the connection speed was 18 megabits per second. So it went up substantially just by disabling encryption, IP leak protection, and DNS leak protection. And I retested it by disabling Speedify, and it was 18.1 megabits per second. So there was a slight drop of speed when using Speedify, but it was significantly less when I disabled encryption and IP and DNS leak protection. Then I tested Speedify again, but this time with using two connections. So one was connected using an Ethernet cable, and the second one was connected using Wi-Fi to a 5G network. So without Speedify, I had a speed of 18.5 megabits per second. That's the upload speed. And with Speedify, the speed was 12.2 megabits per second. And this was with having encryption enabled as well as IP and DNS leak protection enabled. Then I disabled encryption as well as IP and DNS leak protection. And with Speedify, I had a speed of 14 megabits per second. So the speed went up a little bit. And without Speedify, I tested it again and it was 18.5 megabits per second. So under all of the four different tests that I carried out, Speedify always had less bandwidth than if I disabled Speedify and just used my normal network connection. So Speedify is always slower. There's no bandwidth advantage when using Speedify. Latency was improved with Speedify in some of the tests, but this depends on the destination server and its routing to that server rather than Speedify itself. So if the destination streaming server and Speedify servers are on the same cloud provider in the same location, the latency will be very good. Otherwise, it will be slightly worse. But latency is not the real problem when streaming. The low bandwidth is the main obstacle, particularly when using 4G and 5G connections. So the disadvantages of using Speedify is that you'll have less bandwidth, and Speedify also uses up more system resources, such as processing power and memory, which can have a negative impact on video encoding. Also, if you're running Speedify, it will consume more battery. So if you're running Speedify on a phone, the phone's battery will run out quicker. Another more important disadvantage of Speedify is that it's a single point of failure. So a failure in the app will cause disconnection of the stream. Also, a failure in the Speedify servers will cause a disconnection on the video stream. So you have additional points of failure when using Speedify. For example, when you install Speedify, they give you a free trial for, I think, 2 gigabytes or whatever it is. And I tried to use that. And while I was using it, Speedify disconnected my connection. And they essentially gave me a message that I should, buy their package. And this was even before that 2 gigabyte trial had run out. So the app, instead of rerouting your traffic to the normal network connection, it will actually disconnect your network connection completely. So if there's a problem in Speedify, the network connection won't automatically switch to your normal network connection. It will be disconnected altogether. And to me, that's a significant problem. So another place where this problem becomes even a worse problem is that if you're using, let's just say, your 4G or 5G network on your phone, and then you switch on Wi-Fi or switch off Wi-Fi, or maybe you're using Wi-Fi and you switch on or switch off 4G or 5G on your phone, there will be a complete disconnection of network connectivity because of Speedify. So when you want to use Speedify, it seems like you have to set up all your network connections in advance, then enable Speedify, and then there won't be any problems. But while Speedify is running, you can't just switch network connections on and off because it will cause a disconnection to your video stream because of Speedify. So if you're not using Speedify, this problem won't exist. So for example, if you disable your 4G, the phone will automatically start using the Wi-Fi internet connection and vice versa. So this problem with Speedify is a significant problem in my opinion. One of the biggest advantages of Speedify, in my experience, is that it allows you to bypass guest Wi-Fi security for video streaming. So let's just say the guest Wi-Fi is blocking RTMP traffic. When you install Speedify and use Speedify, you can use the guest Wi-Fi connections to stream video, and that will typically be more reliable than using 4G or 5G, in my experience anyway. So I think that's a major advantage, and I think that advantage alone might be a good reason to actually use Speedify. Another potential advantage, although this is a marginal advantage, is that when you're using two connections, if one of the connections is slow, the faster connection can be used for video streaming. And if something temporarily goes wrong with the faster connection, the slower connection will be used, which means the video stream will glitch, but at least the stream will stay up until the main connection is restored, so the stream won't stop. And I think there's some value in that, although it's not a complete solution, but at least the stream will keep running even though it's glitching with a slower connection. But then you know that you have your stream up because of that secondary connection. So in my experience of using Speedify, I would recommend to disable encryption and IP leak protection to increase the bandwidth. And that will increase the bandwidth significantly. So it's definitely worth doing if you're going to use Speedify, let's just say with guest Wi-Fi network connections. Another advantage of disabling encryption and IP leak protection is that it will reduce the demand on the computer or phone which is running Speedify, which means more resources are available for video encoding. And if you're running Speedify on a phone, the phone's battery will last longer. So in terms of security, all the apps on your phone will already be using encrypted traffic, particularly if it's an important app like banking or email. So in my opinion, there's no real advantage of encrypting that data again, which is already encrypted. And I think if you're doing video streaming, for most people, for me anyway, the video streams that I do are going to a public place, so they will be streamed publicly available. So there's no reason for me to want to encrypt that data anyway. And if I wanted to encrypt that data, I would probably be using RTMPS anyway, as opposed to RTMP. So in my opinion, there's no real advantage of enabling encryption. Not for video live streaming anyway. There might be scenarios where you want to use Speedify as a VPN. And obviously in that case, maybe you want to, you know, make sure you have IP leak protection on, DNS leak protection, as well as encryption. But for video streaming publicly available videos, I don't think there's any real advantage of that. But the disadvantage is that you would actually lose out a lot on the bandwidth. So in terms of how I will be using Speedify going forward, I will use Speedify when I'm using guest Wi-Fi connections, because obviously it gives me more bandwidth and more reliability than 4G and 5G. But aside from that, I don't think it can conclusively perform better than the default network connectivity on a phone. For example, if your phone has a 4G connection and you're connecting to a second phone over Wi-Fi, your phone will automatically switch over to the more reliable connection if there's a problem with one of the connections. This approach eliminates the additional points of failure from the Speedify app and their servers while also providing a higher bandwidth. So I don't think it is beneficial to use Speedify in this scenario, and you won't suffer from a disconnection if you decide to enable or disable a particular network setting on your phone during a live stream. So there are too many disadvantages with Speedify to use it effectively, but for connecting to guest Wi-Fi connections, I still think Speedify is a good option and worth using. And just to touch on the support services of Speedify, I've been communicating with them a lot recently after I purchased my Speedify service, and they're quite responsive, so usually get a response within 24 hours, but they don't provide enough information. They have those template type of responses. So for example, if you ask them a specific question, they won't specifically answer your question. They will just provide a set text, which they've probably received from one of the more technical people in the company, and they just send you that. So it's a little bit difficult sometimes to have a productive conversation with the support team when you're trying to get to the root of a problem or try to understand how you can configure Speedify in the best possible way to maximize everything. Anyway, let me know if you have any questions about Speedify, or if you have any experiences with them, or have any suggestions or recommendations on how to use it.